Yeah, peace. Just Shalom, how's everyone? Just want to drop something real quick. The word I am in Hebrew is ani. It means I am. It also means the word I, speaking of yourself. Now, when you say ehye, you're literally saying I will be. And the root of that in Hebrew is the word haya, which means to be or to exist. So Haya itself means he was or it was. Now when you say, as stated, the word Ehye, sometimes said by some people who say Hebrew has no vowels, is said by some as Ahaya. Regardless of whether you say Hebrew had vowels or not, the meaning of the word is still I will be. So that's not a name itself. All right, that's a statement. I will be. Tihye, you will be. Nihye, we will be. So, even though a name can, a person can use a verb as a name, so forth and so on, like you are not breaking the law by saying you wanted to name yourself Elek, which means I will go. You can name yourself that. That's not a rule to state that what a name can and cannot be for a person. But there is no one in the past, in this case I'm speaking of the Most High, when it says, I will be that which I will be, in the Hebrew it says, Ehye Asher Ehye, said by some as Ahaya Asher Ahaya. Regardless of whether you say Hebrew has vowels or not, the meaning of what you're saying is still the same. So when it says, I will be that which I will be, so shall you say to the children of Israel, I will be, or Ehye, or said by some as Ahaya, has sent me unto you. What did the Most High become? He became the Elohim of Israel. That's why in Numbers 15, it says emphatically, I brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am the Lord your God. That's what it states in Numbers 15, verse 40 to 41. So when it says, I will be, or Ehye, that is not the actual name itself. That's making a statement of what will happen. Shalom.